All right, guys, let's take this from the top. I'm already 2 days late. I'm feeling pretty unmotivated, so let's just, like, try to pump this shit out.
It's the Triple Beppo Super Show.
Hey, Roach, that's good for the sad albums, but I think we're gonna try a pretty energetic, like, breakcore, rastacore one this time. Do you think you could,
Chups, please stop chain-smoking Marlboro Reds. I swear to God, you're gonna get us demonetized if you keep this up. You're supposed to be the mascot, but you can't even talk like a normal person. You just go. I could do such a better job if I don't have to worry about my freaking warrant.
Alright guys, cut the shit out. Drop it. We got it. Yeah, because we use copyrighted music in every video. But Roach, for real dude, are you okay? You know, if you want to delay the episode again, that's 100% fine. If you feel like you need a break, that's fine too. We just need the intro, you know?
Listen, I'm trying my best. I pretend to be happy every single freaking intro, and it's tiring. I just want to rest. I love you guys, but seriously, I feel like sometimes you two don't realize that I'm just a human as you are.
Alright, you know what? You're right. I think we all need a little break. We're at each other's throats right now. I think we need some motivation to keep doing this show. But we're not stopping the episode, and we're not resting. You need to sit back, relax, and strap the frick in, and shut your ass up. Get ready for a journey into one of the most peaceful and beautiful albums I've heard in my entire life. If you could encapsulate the beauty of the vast open universe and the astounding probability of our existences into one 1981 Japanese galactic symphony album, this would be the one. I wish that I'd found this album earlier in my life. It is by far one of the most amazing experiences I've ever had, and my only regret with this album is that I didn't drop a 10 strip before listening. That's right, hoes. Get ready for Yuji Ohno's Cosmos.
Wow, now that's rare.
The introductory song is simply titled Prologue. You hear that shit playing in the intro? Words can't even do this arrangement justice. I get chills every time. 10 out of 10. The second song, Sunset, evokes a feeling of majesty and suspense. This is the song that the first Russian cosmonaut, Yuri Gagarin, heard when he broke through the stratosphere and saw our great blue marble in its truest form, in its all-encapsulating beauty.
Beppo, the song wasn't made until 13 years after his death. Shut up!
God himself beamed this symphony straight into Yuri's brain, and you can't convince me otherwise. He got a 12mm syringe of straight will to live and shot it into the man's prefrontal cortex, and it sounded exactly like this. The third song has a spooky synth bass and a spooky intro, but then it gets straight into the funk. It is a song which feels like NASA had a secret mission in which they shot a von Neumann probe full of just 80s vibrations onto Jupiter. I sure hope these aliens got swag, otherwise I'm gonna have to intervene. Song 4, Sailing, hits you with that lovely sax line. I feel like the moon herself has boarded this spacecraft, personified into the most attractive 18-year-old anime girl I could ever imagine, and has proceeded to have passionate intercelestial coitus with me and then all my beloved crew members. I'm not jealous, it's an open relationship type of thing, but she loves me the most, and I know that. And when I return to the Earth and the music is fading out, I'll look into the sky and forever be reminded of that goddess who loves me so. Mom, get out of my room, I'm recording. Stop. Stop, no, please, no. Crystal Lullaby 1 is a song that reminds me of good times that have passed by, but not in a gloomy way. It reminds me of the fleeting nature of life, the moments that pass by that make you think that life is worth living. For all the times that I've felt awful in my life, and for all the times that I think of what I could have done better, this song reminds me of what went right, and everything I should be thankful for. The world is a place of beauty. Beauty in the little moments in which you forget everything. Beauty in the stupidity of taking life too seriously. And beauty in discovering a 1981 Galactic Jazz Symphony for your YouTube channel. Take It to the Sky is another funkadelic song that hits the woodwind melody with an unrivaled grace. I feel like I'm strutting down Hollywood Avenue, but instead of walking on stars bearing the names of egotistical multimillionaire assholes, I'm walking on pure stardust, pure freaking vibes. And by both stardust and vibes, I mean ketamine. Over the Galaxy is a song which is insanely grandiose. The title encapsulates the feeling that this arrangement gives you, but only to a certain extent. When the intro ceases and the synth line comes in, it makes me envision the destination appearing at the farthest reach of my vision. We've gone from admiring the open galaxy coasting along, to calibrating the controls for a proper landing. And as the planet draws closer, its true majesty is unlike any us humans have experienced thus far. Saturn, Pierrot in Heaven, dude, the French just keep on coming for me, is like an amalgamation of funk, galactic symphony, and that cool sax, which is back. Instead of engaging in some saucy intercourse, this time the moon is outside my window, ripping the sax like no other. Frick it, I don't even need physical contact. The sax is so amazing that I have 40 orgasms at once, and I keel over dead due to a burst blood vessel in my brain. But don't worry, God himself brought me back to watch me bust a move to this funky track. Andromeda Smile is a song which acts as a cooldown from the energy of the last number. It sounds like the outro to some sort of season finale, but it definitely isn't the end of the album yet. Then right back into it with the funky bassline, and some horn action to boot. Landing on the Surface of Venus is a song which makes you feel important and cool. At least, more important and cool than some weirdo reviewing obscure music in his bedroom, while his parents overhear him ranting about having sex with the moon. Like, Neil Armstrong or something, you know, he'd never do that, he seemed pretty cool.
Oh my god, Beppo, you're amazing!
Crystal Lullaby 2 acts as a reprise to Crystal Lullaby 1. And it's just as nice, but with a more sort of anime series ending sort of feel. This song better play for me when I die. If there's no heaven, just a short outro with this little reprise composed of a montage of the best moments of my life, I'll be 100% content and 100% happy. Epilogue Sunrise is a reprise to the introduction, so it's fire as you might assume. Its title is a callback to the second song, or, well, first real song aside from the introduction of the album. And those violins, man. The only bad part about this is that it signals the end of the album. Do you even need this segment, really? Were my vivid moon sex analogies not enough for you? This is one of my newest favorite albums now, and it might be one of yours too if you have any semblance of taste in your body. Next time you consume a psychedelic drug, listen to this album, but that's not even a necessity. Words cannot describe the best parts of this album, to be honest. I've never done this before, but Yuji Ohno's Cosmos gets either a 10 or a 9.85 from me. The cast and I didn't even want to make this episode until we heard this masterpiece. Essex Files Episode 1 coming out soon!
Subscribe to make me feel better about my regrets!